Today we will perform activity 10.3 of class 10 chapter light. Here we have to take a concave lens. Here I am having this concave lens and we will place it on a stand, lens stand. I have made this lens stand here. Take a burning candle. We will take a small candle on the same side of the lens. Now we will look through the lens from the other side and observe the image. So here you can see a lens on a lens stand. We have to place the candle, burning candle. First we have to observe the image of the candle on the other side using a screen. We will use a paper. So we are unable to obtain the image on the other side. Okay. Because this concave lens is a diverging lens and it will make the image on the same side. So we have to shift the lens like this. We have to see the candle through this lens. Okay. Now in the activity it is written that we have to move the candle near the lens and we have to move the candle away from the lens. So when I am moving the candle away from the lens, the image is still erect but is becoming smaller and smaller. When I am moving the candle towards the lens, the image becomes large but of small size than the original candle. Here, this is the image and this is the object. You can see the size of object and here you can see the size of image. Here, this is the size of object, this is the size of image. So on moving away from the lens, the size of the image decreases. Here you can see the size, but here the candle is of bigger size. Now in the lens here, this is the image and this is the object. You can see the concave lens always form erect image of smaller size. You can see the difference of image and object. Here you can see. Okay. So the main conclusion from this activity is that a concave lens will always give a virtual, erect and diminished image irrespective of the position of the object.